Hello everyone, today I'm going to be making a Power-Con cable. So first, let me go over the supplies you're going to need. You're going to need all the parts for your Power-Con jack, a screwdriver, wire strippers, and it's helpful if it has a cutter in it, and a razor blade of some sort, or scissors, or something sharp. So here are all the supplies you're going to need for step one. You're going to need your wire strippers and cutters. You're going to need your razor blade and some tape. Any kind of tape will work fine. I'm just using some packing tape because that's what I could find. So you're going to grab your extension cord and you're going to tape the plug end down on the table or desk or whatever you're working on. You want to tape it down so that it doesn't get accidentally plugged in, so that you know you're not going to get electrocuted whenever you're working on these plugs. So next, you're going to take your cable and you want to cut off for about 2 to 3 inches. So I'm going to cut right here, and what I'm going to do is take the razor blade and make a slit. Once you have your slit on this side, you can pull it tight on the other side. Make sure you have it lined up with your first slit. You can pull it tight, and then it'll be much easier to make your second slit. And you're just going to cut all the way around until you get that off. And so right now we're actually just cutting off the end, so it is fine if you make a mistake and cut into one of the wires. Because right now we're just cutting off the Edison jack. So, you've got that, and you're just going to cut through the rest. And it's sometimes helpful to use wire cutters, because those are specifically built for this job. So, if you need to use those, go ahead. There you go. There's your end plug. Now we can get to work on this. So your first step is kind of the same as the last one. You're gonna pull this back, you're gonna bend it, and you're gonna slit it. You're gonna make your slit and just keep slitting it around until you have everything. Until you have this white part cut off. Now you don't want to cut into the wires on this step, because this is when it actually matters that you don't cut the wires, because right here is when this is what's going into your Power-Con jack. So you don't want to have any wires cut or pierced in any way. So just cut around. Until it's completely off. And for this step especially, I really like to use a razor blade, because it's really sharp, and if you pull it tight enough, it's super easy and you don't need to dig into it at all. So, once you've got all that, there might be a little white powder, and you need to pull apart all three wires. So now you're going to do step two, which is to put the Power-Con jack onto the cable. So what you're going to need for this step is your wire stripper, your screwdriver, your Power-Con jack, and your cut cable. So what you do is you first have to put on the back part of the Power-Con jack and slide it as far down as you need, just to keep it out of the way. Then you're going to put what is called the strain relief on, with the pointy ends down and the somewhat flat end up. Then we you're going to strip your three wires. So now you want to twist your wires so that they will go into the jack more easily. So do this with all three. Okay, now that that's done, make sure that your strain relief and back portion of the jack are on your cable, and you are going to take this part of the Power-Con jack and unscrew all three of these garage doors, is what they're called. So unscrew them until the holes are all the way open, but the metal pieces and screw aren't coming out. So now we're going to find the little letters on the plug. So on this one, I don't know if you can tell, but there's an L. On this one, there is an N. And on this middle one, it's Earth. So there's, I don't know where the symbol is for the middle one, but you're gonna, so live is black. Oh, there's the Earth sign is. The Earth sign is in the middle. So you're gonna take the green and put it into Earth. And make sure it's tightened down all the way. Because you don't want these pulling out in your cable, because it's very hard to fix it if they pull out. So tighten it down as tight as you can without stripping it, of course. And then do your next one. So you're gonna put black into the one that has the L. And then screw that down. And then we can assume by process of elimination that the last one, the white cable, goes into neutral. So now that we've got all that done, we want to slide up this white part and line it up. So now you're going to slide this up and line it up. And then you're going to put on the middle part of your plug. Make sure this stays on. And you're going to slide this on, and you can look for this little notch right there. And just slide that over the notch on this. And once that's all the way on, you can slide up the back portion of your jack. Screw it on, it'll click a bunch, and just keep going, until it's all the way up. And that is it. That is how you make a Power-Con cable. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.